Hey everybody, I'm back to do a what's in my school bag video. A lot of people requested me to do this video and my school starts on the 30th, so in about like a little bit over a week. And my school bag isn't completely ready yet, but I will show you guys what I have. It's pretty much set up. I mean, I'm missing a few things, but I will mention them. So if you're still interested in watching this, even though it's not the perfect what's in my school bag video, but it is what I carry, then keep watching. So I mentioned on a vlog and on my Twitter what school bag that I purchased specifically for school, because I need a big bag that can carry a lot of stuff and I don't want to have to carry my purse during school. So I bought this bag and it has like a big bow and a bunch of studs. It has like an extra strap on the back of it. Ooh. And this bag is from Baghouse, or baghaus.com. I'll just type it out down here. I heard it was called Baghouse. This is the Steve Madden Black Knot Tote. I really like it. I saw they were having a back to school code sale. I think it expires soon, so you might want to check it out. It's like a banner on their site. And it was like 30% off. So I got this for like $65, I think, something around that, because it's like originally $98. And it's a big bag. You can see how big it really is, but I mean, it's pretty good for school. It's not too huge, and I'm really skinny, so if it's not too huge for me, not too huge for everyone. So inside the bag, there is a lot of room, like a lot. And there are pockets right here, if you can see that. And the other side, there's a zipper pocket. The zipper of it has a braided detail, which I like. My style, I just love like braids and chains and stuff. So inside my school bag, I already have my love, which you guys know I love Domo so much. So of course I have Domo notebooks, Domo spiral notebooks. And I know everyone's gonna ask me, where'd you get them? I got them from Five Below. I'm not sure if Five Below is everywhere in the world, but it's just a store, kind of like the dollar store. Everything's $5 and below. And they have like school supplies. So I heard from my friend Angela that they had Domo stuff. Like, it's just a spiral notebook and it has wide rule paper. Typically, I like college rule. I've always been a fan of college rule. I just write better with college rule because I have disgusting handwriting. And I have another one. I got this one for free. This was $2. So technically, if you divide it, they're a dollar each. Not bad at all. And I'm sure that I'm gonna get laughed at a couple times in class if someone sees that, but I think I'm just gonna use them to write notes. I also already have some of my books. Like, this is my lab book, and that's the sucky part about going to college. Most of my books are at least this wide, and it just fits perfectly. And I'm gonna put probably like a folder, just like a regular, you know, folder. I wanna get like a Domo one, but I'll see what I can find. Or I just wanna find a cute one. And, you know, just have a couple, maybe one or two folders in there, just throw stuff in. It's like, throw my crap in folder, so it's my crap folder. I have goggles in there, which I had to buy for school. And I'm sure not everyone would carry goggles in their purse. I'm pretty sure it's only for like college science students, but I'm taking a lot of science classes. I'm carrying a Johnson & Johnson first aid kit. I got this also at Five Below. This was like $2. It's like band-aids and moist towelettes and such. I'm a clumsy person in general. I always carried like Dora the Explorer band-aids. If there's Domo band-aids out there, someone contact me. I want some Domo band-aids. But I'm always like a paper cutty person or clumsy or something like that. Or I know people who get hurt, so it's good to have one of those, especially if you're taking dangerous science classes, because I'm horrible with a Bunsen burner. I have a new pencil pouch this year. I get a new one every year. If you look at my old What's My Purse videos, I used to have this black panda one. And mine now is still a little crinkly. It hasn't been broken in yet because it's new, but it's a Domo one. And it's patent leather, so it won't get dirty. Inside, of course, there's a bunch of pens and pencils. I have a bunch of these pens because these are the only type of pens I use. It's like the Precise V5 Extra Fine. I also have this cute little Mashimaro eraser. I love Asian erasers, like the white ones. I don't know if technically would be called Asian erasers, but I only can find them in like Asian trinket stores. They work so much better than pink erasers. They don't shed as much and they erase really, really well without like staining your papers. I don't know if these are technically new, but these are like the most amazing inventions ever to me. I already knew there's like post-it little tab things that are on pens, but this thing is so cool. And one end, the highlighter, has the post-it tabs up here, but under the post-it tabs, there's a pen. So I carry a couple of these, so just in case I need to whip out one of these. I also carry some wet ones because school can be dirty. You guys know I always say that, and for 99 cents and to save yourself a little bit of wipage, it's good. I carry a cute little rose mirror just, you know, to check my makeup in. It has like a magnified side and a non-magnified side. Definitely gotta bring the iPod. I know a lot of people ask me why I don't have any music on my phone, but I just have an iPod and, you know, if you're just waiting between classes or you're bored, it's good to have it. Unless your school says no, do not bring it to school, because if they take it, Don't blame it on me. Gotta have my Q-tip container, because without it, you know, touch-ups, gotta touch up with these. A lot of people know what this is. This is from Glitzy-Glam, which is Blair and Elle's store, which I'll link off in the box. And this is my tampon holder. Yes, my tampon holder all over YouTube, but it's super cute. And, you know, keeps things nice and secret, even though if you know what it is, it's not that much of a secret, but I think it's cute. I bought this a long time ago. Comes in handy. On that note, you gotta bring the Midol, because getting cramps at school is like one of the worst things that could ever happen to you. I feel so bad for anyone, including myself, when you get a lot of cramps at school, because you can't focus and such, and it just ruins your day. So carrying some of this is good, and I typically would carry a drink in this bag too. I also have something I'm pretty sure not a lot of people would have in their purses, but my school requires me to have a clicker, and this is basically like a, it's like a A, B, C, and I click it in class when we had like guest practice tests or something like that. So I had to get one of those. It's like $30. Of course, bring the wallet, because my bag will double up as a purse. And I also threw my Domo makeup bag in there, and if you watched my last What's in My Purse video, you guys know what I carry in here already. I limited it down to just a few things just for school. I'm taking my Rosebud Salve. Lip balm is very important for school. Crusty lips, not cute. That's how much I have left of that. My Rehoto V cooling eye drops. It's good to have eye drops. Let's say you wake up and your eyes just look a little funky, then, you know, or your eyes get irritated, then eye drops are good to have. I'm bringing my portable eyelash curler. And you never know when your lashes fall, or you might need to just boosh your lashes, because lashes make a big difference and make you look awake, so it's not bad to carry some. Paladino's rice paper blotting sheets, and mine is in translucent. Because, you know, school stresses you out, oils, blot blot. And this is probably the most ridiculous thing that I carry, but I bring my backup cargo Blu-ray press powder in shade 20. This is how much I have left of it. This powder is amazing, because if, let's say, my mascara dropped on my face, or I cried, or I fell asleep and I drooled on my face, then the powder will touch it up, makes your face look flawless again. It's great to bring your face powder. You can use it instead of your blotting sheets if you like to, but, you know, it just touches up a lot of things. It's like a magic eraser for any of your mistakes, so it's good to have. I'll bring my Sonia Kashuk retractable kabuki, because this is what I apply my powder with. Small and compact, so, you know, I can throw it in my purse just in case. It's like, if you're the type of person to carry your blush with you because you really need your blush, then you could do that, or your powder, or whatever it is. And though I'm pretty sure I won't use it often, I bring my must-have lipstick, which is Max Cherish. Looks like this. My lip color, but much nicer and nuder. And my must-have MAC lip gloss. It's just like a pinky lip gloss. Let's say I just want to wear a lip gloss, then I can wear this. It's my favorite lip gloss of all time. Hair-wise, I don't bring anything to touch up my hair. At the most, I'd bring my travel hair brush just to, you know, brush my hair. But really, that's it. I'm probably going to bring a lot of headbands, because I love to wear headbands in school. Because let's say you're taking a test and you're looking down. My hair, like, blocks out half my vision. So if I have a headband, I can see a little bit. And I love buying headbands in Forever 21, so I'm probably going to do like a big headband haul eventually. Regardless, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I know it's longer than my usual videos, but I'm talking, so what do you expect? Thank you guys, as always, for watching. I hope you guys enter my giveaway. Remember, it ends on the 28th, which is my birthday. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.